Hi, I'm Ken Bruce. Today, Sarah Cox will be talking to me about my tracks of my ears.
So, Ken Bruce, the tables are turned. These are your tracks of my ears.
I know. I'm so delighted to get the chance at long last and to sit and talk with you.
Of course. Now, normally, of course, you chat to the great and good of, you know, of show business and the music world and pop stars and, you know, personalities. And today it's your turn at last to, you know, grasp the reins of the runaway horse that
it's
is Tracks of My Ears.
It's all about me. Me.
So you've chosen five tracks for this album. What effect did you want to have on people?
I've tried to get sort of songs that make you want to get up and do something, but also I've got at least one or two in there that send the shivers down the spine.
Okay, well, let's get cracking then. The first track, The Snake, from Al Wilson. Tell us about this.
I do love this because it just makes you want to get up and dance. And it's a moral message as well. It means don't mess with things you don't understand.
Northern Soul, big fan of it. Did you go out and dance to it? What sort of era are we talking?
This came out in the late 60s, which is when I got into Soul, actually about the mid 60s, because it was big in Glasgow at the time. I used to go to dances and people were playing this, but they'd be playing their own versions of it. But it was just such bright and engaging music, and you just wanted to get on the floor as soon as you heard it.
Okay, your next track, How Does It Feel, from Slade.
Slade, now you see, people think of Slade as being, oh, that loud band who make a lot of noise and spell their song titles a bit oddly. But this is their best song, and it could be, I think Noel Gallagher was on record as saying that this is one of the best pop songs ever. And I think it is. Noddy's singing on it is so soulful, it's absolutely beautiful, and it's a song that I think will still be played in 100 years' time, and it proves that Slade are for life and not just for Christmas.
So your next track, Nina Simone, I Put a Spell on You.
This is just a fantastic track. This is the real kind of, if I had hair on the back of my neck, that's where it would, this is when it would be standing up. Nina Simone is a terrific singer. She was a terrific performer. She took her audiences on the same way she took on fellow professionals. If they weren't behaving, she called them out and said, sit down, stop talking, that sort of thing. And she could absolutely nail a song. The other great element of this is just the pace it's taken out. It's so kind of relaxed and easy and bluesy. She's doing the tinkling piano here and there, which is great. And they have a fantastic bit of saxophone playing by King Curtis. It's a beautiful, beautiful recording.
Your next track, Ken, is Amy McDonald's Poison Prince. You a big fan of Amy?
Huge fan. I think Amy McDonald is still going to be heard and seen and listened to in years and decades to come. She is the genuine article.
She played live for you before?
She has. She's played live on this show. She played live in Glasgow, outside broadcast for us.
Where's she actually from?
From Glasgow, yes. Yeah. She's from Bishop Briggs, but she was born, I think, 2 or 3 years after I left Glasgow.
And what's the story with Poison Prince?
I believe it's about Pete Doherty and his difficulties in his career in songwriting. I just think she's fantastic.
So we're going to play the final track now, Ken, The Four Tops, and I Can't Help Myself. Did you ever get to see them play live?
Yes, I did. I did. Fantastic. And lived up to every expectation. That's the great thing with these fantastic Motown bands. They could do it. They could reproduce that sound anywhere they went. Even if it wasn't exactly the same,
Yeah. It
was still very, very close to it. And they could all sing. They were fantastic.
Great chatting to you. Thanks very much.
Thank you.